go.
How do we get these really important messages across to people? How do we educate ourselves and others? And I think books are important because they give us enough time in a long format to express ideas that where formats like we're in now don't really allow us to get in there. I mean, a format like this where we can talk for an hour is fantastic. But the reality is that whilst, you know, most people won't read my book, a lot of people won't watch this while a lot of people will, but most people will watch like a, if you did a 5-minute grab of this interview and with the best parts as an ad, for instance, most people will watch that. And if you're able to, in that 5 minutes, simplify those messages into bite-sized chunks, then and repeat that and repeat that and repeat that, that's something that people will carry forward. So our savior, you know, salvation, I should say, in the future, in terms of self-knowledge, does weirdly tie in with what you're saying with materialism. I think that we can't turn away from, I don't really appreciate social media, but it is there. And I would be an idiot to say we're just going to kind of look away from it in the same way that we thought that the internet might have been a fad in the 90s. And it really was questionable whether the internet was a fad or not. These things are a part of our life. iPhones are a part of our life. And I would be fundamentalist and prohibitionist if I said for myself and my children that, you can't do this. And so we're struggling to figure out what's the balance. I deleted the Gmail app off my phone so that I was forced to sit down at the computer and get my email that way. In the same way that I say, well, I'm only ever going to have a 6-pack of beer in the fridge, so that I'm not tempted to go past that in any single evening. And, you know, 6 beers in a night is definitely probably not a good idea. So you're right. The way of learning and teaching these things in the future is in a way being, you know, working concurrently with the technology and also just with a pragmatic way, the facts of life. iPhones are a fact of life. Zoom is now a fact of life. What you and I are doing right now is a fact of life. And we are only fools to turn away from it and to assume that we can go back to reading a book, you know, and hoping that all the wisdom falls upon us and it will everyone else. I would say this lastly, I'm a huge lover of books, and that it is a really important way to get information, but I don't for a second think that most people will receive it that way.